So technology has the power to completely shape our lives. We have seen that over and over again, but it also can alter our bodies in unexpected ways when we don't do the same things that we've been doing for years because of that technology. So researchers discovered young people are developing horn-like spikes on the back of their skulls due to long periods of time spent looking down at their mobile devices. The study found it affects roughly 40% of 18 to 30-year-olds, especially young males, and that might have to do something with all the gaming. So joining me now is Dr. Mark Spatola. He is a neurosurgeon with Orange Park Medical Center, and appreciate you coming in.
Thank you.
You know, we don't want to dramatize this story, because I think when you hear horns, people are like, what is going on? They're feeling it for the base of their skull. But when it comes to this is really, these are bone spurs that are forming in the area because of just that kind of hunched over, your neck is not in its proper position.
That's right. They're not horns. They're bone spurs growing off the back of the skull. From bending our heads forward, from using mobile devices, cell phones, and tablets. And they were more common in young males, roughly 40% in 18 to 30-year-olds. And normally we see these in older patients, and so this is a change.
And even smaller numbers.
Yes, yeah. Yes. So it's an increase, and also in a younger age group. And the thought here is from the mobile devices.
Why does the body form these spurs just from that kind of posture?
Well, from bending our head forward, rather than keeping it straight, mm-hmm. and looking down at texting and at mobile devices, which is a new phenomenon in the last decade or two.
Yeah, and we're starting to see the effects of that. Is this dangerous? What symptoms will a person feel if they experience this?
No, it's probably not dangerous or significant. I think the more important issue here is that this may be a part of what we call texting neck, mm-hmm. which is increased headaches and neck pain from having our head bent forward and our neck bent forward, and may develop into degenerative discs and arthritis in the neck, which over time could become more serious, leading to have to see someone like myself, a neurosurgeon, and even go to surgery.
Yeah, and so the key here is that we want to think about using our good posture. And you know, if you're on your phone for 5 minutes, you know, in the morning, 5 minutes in the afternoon, that's not such a big deal. But we're finding people, you know, 30 minutes in the morning, a couple hours in the evening, and you never do what you're really supposed to do, which is quite awkward, is to lift the phone up, you know, tilt your head back, and do this when you're texting, which you never see anybody do.
Well, it's exactly right. Yeah. It's right. We're all guilty of it, of looking down. And the answer is to try to raise the phone up. If you're using a tablet, use a pillow, or to try to use a stand. And put the phone down
right.
Once in a while.
Right, which is hard to convince people to do.
Yes. Well, the manufacturers are now even putting tracking programs on.
Right.
For us to keep track of this so we know how often we're using the phones.
What do you think it's going to take for people to really kind of get that message and then apply these different techniques to help with that pain, potentially?
I think getting the word out like we're doing now so that people really concentrate on keeping their good posture, which is a general principle not only for the neck but for the back and for all of our joints.
So if this does develop into pain, what type of surgery would they potentially need to help with this?
Well, for someone that if they have disc disease or bone spurs in the neck, then they could have a discectomy or posterior operation. And those are relatively serious procedures, but, you know, pretty commonplace.
Yeah, is this something you're concerned about, you know, maybe 10, 15 years down the line if
yes.
habits don't change?
Absolutely. Yeah. At the middle age and older, that may create problems that are going to require intervention.
All right, so while you're young, folks, make this cool. You know, here's my thing, like, make it cool to look at your phone this way, because right now it's probably not so much, but there are some changes that we all can make to help to have better care in our neck. So if you missed any of this information and you want to know more about it, just go to newsforjax.com. We'll post this interview on our web channel. Thank you for coming in.
Oh, my pleasure.